The president has this week assented to several tax bills, to the Lotteries and Gaming Amendment Act 2023, a move that will see government increase the amount of withholding tax one pays after winning in sports betting and gaming from 20% to 30%. A move government says is aimed at streamlining the sector and set clarification on how the tax is meant to be paid. The tax measure will exclude winning from casinos, slot machines and lotteries from the scope of withholding tax due to the confusion in determining the tax to be paid.
Next financial year, there is a bit of laxity. We are looking for money, but we are careful not to impose taxes on Ugandans as we try to recover. As we try to recover from COVID, from Ebola, from the moving island.
The development comes at a time when the National Lotteries and Gaming Board revealed in March 2023 that in the current financial year 2022-2023, 119.844 billion shillings will be collected in revenue as proceeds and licensing of sports betting and gaming across the country. President Museveni also signed into law the Traffic and Road Safety Amendment Act 2023, increasing the fine for motorists driving beyond the prescribed speed limit from 200,000 shillings to 2 million shillings or a jail sentence of 3 years. The proposal is intended to restore sanity on roads and reduce road carnage on Uganda's roads.
Proposing is a maximum penalty. So if you go to court, there is a maximum that you can pay, which can range. It could be, which can range, but the maximum is 2 million, depending on the severity of the offense. Yeah. So the members were uncomfortable with it, actually, and it was left to the minister to impose by regulation.
The Value Added Tax Amendment Act 2023 was also passed into law, approving an 18% tax levy on both baby and adult diapers. It should be recalled that in March 2023, the Minister of Finance tabled before Parliament the Value Added Tax Amendment Bill 2023, proposing to end the blanket tax exemption on all diapers, but have it reserved for adult diapers on medical grounds while having the levy imposed on baby diapers. Government argued that, whereas the people using baby nappies in rural areas are paying taxes on these items, people using diapers aren't paying any taxes, yet the items are a luxury. Government revealed that 2.6 billion shillings would be raised from taxes on diapers.
Should accept the principle that in considering these bills, we said there should be no tax increase. That's one. But on the other hand, we need taxes in order to pay for the services. We need good roads, we need drugs in hospitals, we need to repair the hospitals, we need the schools repaired first class. The only way of paying for them is by taxes.
Still in the Value Added Tax Amendment Act 2023, Parliament approved the proposal that would allow taxpayers to pay their taxes in both dollars and Uganda shillings after complaints from international and non-resident taxpayers that the dollar rates of URA are higher than the market value, which has subjected them to pay higher taxes than their counterparts. Under the Excise Duty Amendment Bill, Ugandans will part with 75 shillings on every litre of bottled water, or whichever is higher, in addition to the 10% levy. The new tax is meant to close out possibilities of under-declaration by some manufacturers in the water industry.
We wanted a 10% on bottled water, but then the members decided no.
In enhancing tax administration, Parliament approved 100 million shillings fine or a jail term of 10 years for companies that tamper with digital stamps.
The reason why we raised that penalty, I think you'll agree with me that these digital platforms are the ones helping us raise money at the moment, and they have greatly helped URA in tax administration. We are therefore concerned that anybody interfering with them causes us a loss.
Staff of the Office of the Directorate of Public Prosecutions will eat big in the coming financial year after Parliament exempted their salaries. The exemption is contained in the Income Tax Amendment Bill 2023, but it may not take effect from today, since the president returned the bill to parliament for reconsideration and some clauses. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.